Good morning, sirs. Welcome to BSc1 Geology class. So in the last video, we were talking about classification of phylum Protozoa. In continuation of that, the second subphylum. So first subphylum of Protozoa is Sarcomastrophora. Sarcomastrophora is complicated. Second subphylum, Sporozoa. Let us talk about subphylum Sporozoa. The general characteristics. The first general characteristic is the bird has no external organs of locomotion. The adult individuals belonging to this subphylum are not having external locomotory organs like Sauropodia, Plasella. They are absent here. Plasella and Sauropodia lacking, they are totally absent. Okay, they are all parasitic and incapable of active life outside their host. They are all parasitic, they all lead parasitic life, they are not leading free life, they are not leading free life, they are leading parasitic life. They are parasites, parasites, they live in other animals, human beings or vertebrates or invertebrates. Okay, they live parasitic life. They are all parasitic and incapable of active life outside their host. They are incapable of leading active life outside their host. Outside their host. If at all they want to survive, they have to be inside their host. Inside their host, not outside their host. If they are outside their host, they cannot lead active life. Active life means they have to survive. They have to lead parasitic life. Otherwise, they cannot survive. Then cilia or flagella may be present in gametes. Cilia or flagella may be present in gametes, not in adults. Their gametes may possess pseudopodia or flagella, not their adults. Next, syngamy takes place after which many spores are formed. Syngamy means fusion of gametes. So syngamy takes place after many spores are formed. Many spores are formed. After the formation of spores, syngamy takes place. Okay? Then spores are simple and contain one to many sporozoites. Production of spore is the characteristic feature of subphylum Sporozoa. Production of spores. What are spores? I told you, they are asexual reproductive structures. Asexual reproductive structures. So these spores are simple and contain one to many sporozoites. They contain one to many sporozoites. Sporozoites means they are infective stage. They are pathogenic. They are pathogenic stages. They are pathogenic phase. See, in parasitic forms, there are two phases. Mature form, mature phase, and pathogenic phase. Mature phase is for trophozoite, and pathogenic or infective stage is called sporozoite. So sporozoites are present inside the spores. Then nucleus is the simple type. Nucleus is of simple type, very simple. Okay. So these are the general characteristics of subphylum Sporozoa. Under this subphylum, class 1, Telosporia. Class 1, Telosporia. The general characteristics of Telosporia. Pseudopodia are absent and locomotion is by gliding or body flexion. By gliding movement, since they don't have Pseudopodia or Plasella, how can they move? By moving their body. Gliding movement or body flexion, they can move to some extent. Since they don't have locomotive structures like your Sauropodia and Plasella, they are completely lacking here. Then spores are formed and these are plasellated microgametes in some. Spores are formed and these are plasellated. So they have facilitate microgametes, then reproduction is both sexual and asexual. Reproduction is both sexual and asexual. Okay? Example, very good example is Plasmodium. Plasmodium. So Plasmodium, Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax is a malarial parasite. It's a malarial parasite. It spreads malaria, fever, malaria disease in human beings. And the occurrence of Plasmodium, it is widely distributed. It is found in tropical and temperate regions, and they complete their life cycle in 2 hours. They are diagenetic. Plasmodium vivax is a diagenetic. It completes its life cycle in 2 hours. Man and mosquito. Man and mosquito. In man, asexual, the life cycle takes place. Sexual life cycle occurs in mosquito. Mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito. So this female Anopheles mosquito spreads this disease from person to person by inoculating pathogenic phages called sporozoites. Sporozoites. Sporozoites are inoculated into the bloodstream of human beings while the mosquitoes are biting to the human beings. They inoculate, they release sporozoites into the bloodstream, and they multiply, they lead asexual life cycle in human beings. Okay, by producing spores. Later on, they enter into mosquitoes' body, where they are converted into gametes, macrogamete and microgamete. After their fusion, you know, new egg ones are formed. Okay, Plasmodium vivax belongs to this class, Plasmodia. Okay, so we are talking about classification of protozoa. Under protozoa, four subphyla are there. First subphylum is completed. First subphylum is Sarcomastrophora, characterized by the presence of Sauropodia or the Flagella as their locomotive structures. Subphylum 2, sporozoans. Sporozoans don't have locomotive structures, but they produce spores. Okay? Under sporozoa, class 1 is Neurosporia. Under Neurosporia, very good example is Plasmodium vivax. So next class. Okay. Next class is class Toxoplasmia. Class 2, Toxoplasmia. Its general characters are spores are absent here. Spores are absent. There are no flagella or sauropodia at any stage. No sauropodia or flagella at any stage. Whether in their adults or in their spores. Spores are absent here in any stage, pathogenic stage or non-pathogenic stage. They are not having either the flagella or sauropodia. Okay? So reproduction by binary fission. Reproduction is only by binary fission. No? Sexual reproduction occurs. Binary fission, you know it. When the organism or the animal reaches its maximum size, it undergoes fission, division. So binary fission, parental individual divides into two daughter cells. Binary fission. By binary fission, they divide asexually. Then cysts are formed which have many naked sporozoites, cysts. So these individuals, what they do when during unfavorable condition, they produce cysts around themselves, around their body. Cyst is developed. Cyst is nothing but protective layer. Protective covering is formed, and this protective cover protects the animal which is present inside. when normal conditions are arrived and the cyst is ruptured, the inverts are released. So cysts are formed which have many naked sporozoids. After breaking the cyst, sporozoids are released. You know what are sporozoids? Sporozoids are pathogenic phases. Okay, sporozoids are infective stages. They spread disease. Okay, example, toxoplasma spreads. Toxoplasmosis in human beings. Symptoms of toxoplasmosis. So next, the symptoms of this disease are the muscle pain, fever, fatigue, headache. These are the symptoms of this disease. Toxoplasmosis caused by toxoplasma in human beings. So that's about the class 2 toxoplasmia. Then second class, the third class, Haplosporia. Okay, here spores are absent. Pseudopodia may be present, but flagella are absent. Pseudopodia may be present. Not sure, may be present. Pseudopodia like structures might be observed. So pseudopodia may be present, but flagella are absent, completely lacking. Reproduction is only a sexual method. And schizomorphic stress. Schizomorphic, multiple fission. So you know, binary fission, like that multiple fission occurs, that leads to production of many inverts. Example, Ischiosporidia comes in the Haplosporia. So these are the three classes that come under subphylum sporozoa. And the next subphylum, third subphylum, is Neurospora. So next subphylum is Neurospora. So here spores have several cells having one or more polar filaments which are coil threads and can be shot out. Coil threads are there in the spores of these Neurospora. Neurospora spores are having threads like this. Threads, thread like structures, filaments. Spores have several cells having one or more polar filaments which are coiled threads and can be shot out. Okay, because of the presence of thread like structures, these have been added to this subphylum, Neurospora. All are parasitic. Zygote gives rise to one or more protozoa. Sexual reproduction is there. So zygote, after the fusion of gametes, zygote is formed. Zygote gives rise to one or more protozoids. Protozoids are mature stages without producing spores. Mature embryos are formed by the zygotes. So under this class 1, Mixosporidia. Spores are of multicellular origin. Here spores are of multicellular origin. It is originated from several cells. Okay. There are one or more sporoplasmas with two or three walls. Two or three walls are there. So they are parasitic in fishes. Fish parasites there. Fish parasites are also protozoans. Mixobolus. Mixobolus is born in fishes. They are fish parasites. Okay, next one. Class 2. Mixosporidia. Mixosporidia has spores of unicellular origin. Here, these are of multicellular origin. It is here, unicellular origin. And there is one long tubular polar filament. One long tubular polar filament through which the sporoplasmas emerge. Sporoplasma emerge, they come out of the spores. They are cytozoic in arthropods. Cytozoic means intracellular. They are intracellular parasites. Inside the cell they are present, like Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax is also intracellular. It is present inside the RBCs of human beings. RBCs of human beings. So they are cytozoic in arthropods and vertebrates. Example, Nosema. Nosema bulbosis is a popular known example which spreads disease in silkworms. Silkworms are affected by Nosema bulbosis. Parasitic protozoa. So silkworm also belongs to phylum Arthropoda. They are affected by Nosema. So this is second class. So it has Leptospora. Leptospora subphylum has two classes. And the next subphylum, the last subphylum is Cereophora. The last subphylum is Cereophora. Cereophora. So general characters of Cereophora. First characteristic feature: all possess simple ciliary organs for locomotion. Yes, cilia are present here. In sarcopods, either sauropodia or flagella are present. Whereas here in Cereophora, cilia are present as their locomotory organelles. So with the help of which animals can move and also capture their food organisms. So for locomotion as well as for capturing food organisms, same locomotory organelles are used. Okay? They have two nuclei. This is very important. Two nuclei. All ciliates have two nuclei. One is larger and another is smaller. Larger one is called the trophic nucleus or macronucleus. Smaller one is called as sexual nucleus or micronucleus. Okay? So a trophic macronucleus and a diploid micronucleus. Here in paramecium, you get this diagram. This is paramecium. This is DNA. It has two nuclei. One is larger, another is smaller. Larger one is called macronucleus, smaller one is called micronucleus. Okay? So larger one is not being used during the sexual reproduction. Only the micronucleus is used for sexual reproduction. Exchange of genetic material. Exchange of nucleus occur between two paramecia during a conjugation process. Whereas macronucleus is not being exchanged. And this is important for the development of the body. Body genes are present here in the macronucleus. So usually ciliates have two types of nuclei, dimorphic nuclei. Therefore, in case of Opalina, though it has several nuclei, all nuclei are of only one type. Monomorphic. Therefore, the Opalina has cilia-like structures. Cilia-like locomotory structures, but they are not cilia. Ciliates usually possess two nuclei, but they only one type of nuclei present. Therefore, they are not ciliates. Opalinata doesn't come under ciliata. Okay. Next, myelin fission. Asexual reproduction occurs by myelin fission. So transverse myelin fission takes place. Transverse like this. Fission occurs. Okay. In case of glia, longitudinal myelin fission takes place. Whereas in case of paramecium, transverse myelin fission occurs. Okay. Next, conjugation takes place with fusion of nuclei. Conjugation takes place. Conjugation process occurs. Sexual reproduction occurs here by conjugating, by meeting up of two animals during the time of exchange of nuclei. Nutrition is mixotrophic or heterotrophic. Mixotrophic or heterotrophic. Mixotrophic, I told you. In case of euglena, euglena in presence of light, it can synthesize its own food. Right? In absence of light, it takes food from the surrounding medium. Like that, here the paramecium also men, not only paramecium, these are these ciliates. They show mixotrophic, saprozoic, heterotrophic, holozoic type of nutrition, or heterotrophic, heterotrophic, holozoic, animal life. And in absence of light, they can feed on other organisms. They usually have cytostome. Stome means mouth. Cell has mouth. This is opening of the cell. This is called cytostome. Through this cytostome, food is taken into the body. So, ciliates have cytostome. Okay? Sporozoans have no cytostome. So, example, class, only one class is a ciliata, but this class, paramecium, serenta, corticella, many organisms are, many animals. So, paramecium, this is a very good example for ciliates. Ciliates, it lives in freshwater ponds, freshwater bodies. So, where the organic food is more, there they can survive. Paramecium. So these are ciliates. Cilia is present all over the surface of the body. These cilia are used for locomotion and capturing food organisms. Food vacuoles are there for digesting food intracellularly. Then the entire animal is extremely covered by pellicle. Thin pellicle is there. It has two nuclei, macronucleus, micronucleus. Okay? It reproduces by both processes, asexually as well as asexually. We have completed the classification of protozoa, and in the next class, I will be dealing with locomotion in protozoa. Thank you.